that really depends on you as a person. I'm naturally quite introverted and I used to be very shy, and there is stuff, you know, there is a part of me that is quite shy, so I enjoy spending time by myself. I love spending time with my friends and family, so I still do travel with friends and I still do travel with family. Traveling by yourself, you don't have to take other people's wants and desires into consideration. If you feel like laying in bed all day, then there's no, you don't have to consider what somebody else wants to do. But in terms of like addressing the loneliness, I think that comes down to the individual. So just think about how you are in your day-to-day life. I know there are times where I don't really see people, I just have things going on, everybody else has things going on, and you know, I'll be by myself. In London, I don't always need someone, well, definitely don't always need someone to do things, to go shopping, to explore the place, to go around my kind of day-to-day life. If you're able to do that in your own city, your own country, then you're able to do it abroad. You just have to take common sense with you. So I think if there's a balance between being open to trying new experiences, but also having a kind of sense of, just a sense of caution and not doing anything you would not do in your own country. So for example, I came across this YouTube video about scams in China, in Beijing, that target tourists, and I think they call it like the tea shop scam. They would start talking to you, they would pretend that they're from another place in China, and then they'd be like, let's go for a coffee. They wouldn't say where they're going, you'd end up walking through all these different streets, so you've kind of lost your bearings, and they'll take you to a coffee shop. The menu is written in Mandarin, so I mean, unless you're multilingual or bilingual, you speak and read Mandarin, you have no idea what's on the menu. They have a few things that are written in English with the letters, and then by the time you get the bill is £300 for three cups of tea and a bag of crisps, and they have heavy bouncers there, so you're kind of forced to pay. But I just think, would you do that in your own country? Would you go to a coffee shop with like strangers and, you know, not be able to understand what's going on? Fair enough, sometimes, you know, we meet people when we're out and about, but you might decide on the place. If you're in a country you don't know, you want to meet someone you've just met, decide, you decide on the place, you take control of the situation. If you feel like something is off, listen to what your gut is saying. Your gut will never mislead you. If you are open to traveling and you do want to stay in low-cost accommodation, there's always hostels and there are always homestays. Hostels are great for meeting other travelers, so if you are worried about being alone, a hostel is a great place. If you do not want to share dormitories, there are hostels that have the dormitories which have 8 beds in it, but they also might have rooms that you can actually stay in and have that to yourself, and a bathroom to yourself if you don't want the shared facilities. But a hostel is a great way of meeting other travelers, and then you can essentially meet other travelers, do your activities and explore the place with another set of travelers, so you're not by yourself. Homestays are great because you're with a local family, so even if you spend the day by yourself, you're usually with them for breakfast and dinner, and they can also refer you to the best places to go. They can also introduce you to people, so that's a way of getting over the loneliness, those two types of accommodation. And then another thing with, this is linked to loneliness and safety and security, get a local SIM card. Do not depend on just having Wi-Fi in your hotel or when you go for lunch and dinner. With a local SIM card, you can get in contact. If you need help, you can call your hotel and ask for help, or whoever whatever contact you have in that country, you're more than welcome to ask for help. If you don't have a local SIM card, you might not have roaming available, but if you do have roaming available, you're going to be charged £100 a second to make a phone call. If you don't have an international plan. But a local SIM card also means that you have data anytime, any place, wherever you are, so that you're not just dependent on Wi-Fi hotspots. So for example, if you get lost, GPS to the rescue, Google Maps to the rescue. If you need to speak to your friends and family because you're feeling lonely or you just want to touch base, you can do so at any time. You don't have to wait until you get home in the evening or late at night when the time difference might not work for calling your family or speaking to your friends. You've got access to the internet at all times, because you don't need minutes to make a call to your family. There's WhatsApp, there's Facebook Messenger, there's a whole heap of calling apps that you can use at your disposal. Another thing which is quite difficult to figure out via YouTube or without having been there is if it's a place that has a nighttime culture. And by nighttime culture, I don't mean pubs and clubs and bars. I mean night markets, eating quite late, these sorts of things where families are kind of involved in it. They usually are pretty safe. If I'm in a place where, and I mean not foreigners, I mean local people, where local people are out late at night in the markets, eating, you know, with their families, then I know it's a pretty safe place. Okay, so when things lock off at 6 p.m, then you need to kind of make sure that you're in at that time. So if you know that the place has a nighttime culture, then that's all you're in to find it out. Then you kind of know actually it is quite safe. Families are out, it's safe for people to be out. Although I feel like there are, in every country, there are dangerous places and dangerous people. You just have to operate with that in mind. I think inherently most people are good, it's just a few people that are not so good, and you just have to have your wits about you. I don't think it's about traveling to a safe or unsafe place. Now obviously there are a few places that I probably wouldn't travel to by myself, but when I do travel by myself, I like to be aware of my surroundings, of the people. Don't tell people where I'm staying. Sometimes I don't tell people. If people ask me if I'm by myself, I might not answer that truthfully. One of the questions that I always get, where are you from? What's your name? The answers to these questions, I change up depending on how I feel. Sometimes I say London, sometimes I say the Caribbean, which isn't a lie. My family is from St. Lucia. Sometimes I say Zimbabwe, sometimes I say Kenya, sometimes I say Nigeria, and technically that isn't a lie. I am of African descent. So, but you don't have to tell people your business. The next point is be assertive. Do not be afraid to say no. So for example, if you're at the airport and there's somebody there, let me help you with your baggage. People don't do something for nothing. Expect that if someone wants to show you around or they want to carry your bags or do something for you, expect that they want something, whether it be payment or something else. So do not be, unless you're willing to pay that person, do not be afraid to say no. No, I do not want your items, but have a good day. Good luck selling them. So you don't have to be rude, but be firm and be assertive. Know that this is your holiday, you paid your money to go away, and you should do the things that you want to do. Do not let people overtake your holiday with what they want. And also at the same time, don't let it bother you. These people are on a hustle. I don't get angry with people trying to sell me things or then try being a bit pushy with it, because they're on a hustle. That is their bread and butter. is conflicting. Sometimes people can't do it for whatever reason or don't want to do it. You should not let that limit you. What other people want to do, you should not let that stop you or hinder you from doing what you want to do. So I say, if you're thinking about traveling abroad, take the leap and just do it. Do not be afraid to be alone. You will meet lots of people. I always meet people when I'm traveling. If you're just open to the experiences, you know, you'll have a fabulous time. And you know, there is nothing better than this. Look at this. Look at where I am right now. If I wasn't open to traveling by myself, right now I would be sitting in cold, miserable, wet London, whereas right now I get to experience the beauty, which is Cape Verde, and I'm absolutely grateful for that. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, so please subscribe and give me the thumbs up, comment below, and I will see you soon.